Children, today we will learn about the use of data table. Today is Barbole Uncle's birthday. All friends are going to come to the birthday party. Uncle has bought a lot of fruits for the party. Apples, mangoes, bananas, oranges, guava, chikku, so many fruits. But what is this? Uncle looks upset. Chanda has come to Uncle's house to help him. Seeing Uncle upset, Chanda asked him,
Uncle, why are you so upset?
Uncle told Chanda,
I have to make delicious barfi for the guests. But there are so many fruits here that I cannot understand which fruit has the maximum quantity among all of these.
Chanda told Uncle,
I will help you. You count the apples and I will count the guavas.
Chanda and Uncle started counting fruits together. Uncle counted the apples. The total number of apples is 28. Chanda counted the guavas. The total number of guavas is 35. Now Chanda asked Uncle to count the mangoes and she herself started counting chikkus. Once again, both of them started counting the fruits. Upon completion, it is found that Uncle has 32 mangoes and Chanda has 13 chikkus. In the end, Uncle quickly counted the oranges. Uncle has 47 oranges. After counting all the fruits, Chanda asked Uncle, how many apples did he say there were? Uncle tried very hard to remember, but he could not remember the number of apples. Uncle was sad that both of their efforts were completely wasted. Chanda told Uncle,
Don't be sad, Uncle. I have another solution for this too.
Chanda quickly made a table like this on a paper.
Uncle, we can use this table to write down the number of fruits so that we don't forget them when we finish counting them. Here I have written the names of all the fruits. As we finish counting the fruits, we will write the total number in front of the name of that fruit in this table. In this way, when we finish counting all the fruits, then the numbers of all those fruits would have also been recorded, and we can very easily find which fruit is largest in number. Uncle, do you remember the number of oranges?
Chanda asked Uncle. Uncle immediately said,
47.
Chanda wrote this number in front of the orange in the table like this. Uncle and Chanda once again counted all the fruits and wrote their numbers in the table. The table is finally complete. Children, have you seen such a data table? Like Uncle, if we want to find the numbers of many objects and draw some kind of conclusion from it, then we can use the data table. Chanda asked Uncle,
Uncle, can you now tell which fruit is largest in number?
Children, by looking at this table, can you tell which fruit is the largest in number? Well done! Your answer is absolutely correct. The total number of oranges, 47, is the largest. Now, can you tell which fruit is the smallest in number? Correct! number of chikus. 13 is the smallest number. Children, in this way, you can get various kinds of information by using the data table. Uncle 2, with the help of Chanda's table, found that the number of oranges was the largest. Chanda and Uncle together started preparing to make orange barfi. Children, in this lesson, we learned about the use of data table. In the next video, we will learn more about it by some interesting examples. Previous video, we learned about the use of data table. In this video, we will learn more about it through some interesting examples. Chanda is returning home after helping Uncle with his party preparations. She met Golu on the way. Golu asked Chanda,
"Chanda, what will you gift Uncle for his birthday?"
Chanda remembered that she had many colorful beads. She told Golu,
"Why don't we both make a necklace of beautiful beads for Uncle?"
Golu quickly agreed and both came to Chanda's house. Chanda had a box filled with many different colored beads. Golu got very excited on seeing red, green, blue, yellow, and white beads. He made a drawing of blue and yellow beads on a paper like this and said to Chanda,
"Chanda, let's make a necklace of this design."
Children, how many yellow and blue beads do you see in Golu's design? Yes, Golu's design consists of 12 yellow and 6 blue beads. But all the beads are scattered. Chanda and Golu are not able to understand whether they have enough blue and yellow beads to make the necklace according to Golu's design or not. Chanda immediately remembered that she could also find a solution to this problem by making a data table. She and Golu together counted the number of beads and wrote them in a data table like this. Children, can you see this table and tell if Chanda and Golu have enough beads to make their necklace? If you want, you can stop the video and find the answer. Yes, Chanda has 10 blue beads, and to make the necklace according to Golu's design, she only needs 6 blue beads. Therefore, Chanda has enough blue beads to make the necklace. In the same way, how many yellow beads does Chanda have? 25. And how many yellow beads does she need? 12. In this way, Chanda also has enough yellow beads for making the necklace. Golu looked at the table and said,
"Chanda, we can use one of the other color beads too, instead of the yellow beads."
Which color beads can Chanda use instead of yellow colored beads? That's correct. According to the design made by Golu, Chanda needs 12 yellow beads. We can see in the table that only 34 is more than 12, which is the number of white colored beads. Therefore, to make the necklace, Chanda can also use white colored beads instead of yellow colored beads. Chanda liked Golu's suggestion very much. Now, Chanda and Golu together made a necklace of white and blue beads for Uncle. Children, in this video we learnt more about the use of a data table through some interesting examples.